I'm Tony D. Nothing says killer gaming rig like a phenomenal paint job. And it is pretty easy to do. The thing is there are a couple tutorials out there on the internet on how to paint your case. The problem is they leave a few things out. And the few things they leave out or mess up just a little bit actually are a big deal. So what I wanted to do was show you from soup to nuts really quick how to paint a computer case the correct way so you have the basics to a killer paint job for your gaming rig. So let's get started. One of the most critical steps to painting a computer case is the prep of the materials you're getting ready to paint. A lot of people will pull a computer case apart, they'll spray paint the crap out of it, and it looks like garbage. Well, it's because they didn't prep their project correctly. It actually is pretty easy, but there are some tricks. The biggest tricks? Well, you're dealing with two types of material here. Plastic, like the front part of the case, and metal, the back part of the case, the main cover of the case. And the way you prep those two materials is actually pretty different, and it's important that you get it right, because if you don't, that's why your paint job is gonna look like garbage, and we're not gonna do that. Ours is gonna look awesome. So, let me show you how to prep plastic and metal correctly. We're gonna do some killer stuff to this old dinosaur of a case. So let me walk you through what we're actually gonna do. It's already got a disk drive. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the face off of the disk drive and then paint it with the rest of the case so it blends right in. Now down here, nobody uses 3x5 drives anymore. So I'm gonna get rid of this space. Well, I got a pretty cool plan to do it. I'm gonna use fiberglass to cover over this hole right here and this portion, and then basically smooth out all these lines right here. Once I got the fiberglass in there and it gives it some structure, then I'm gonna come in with some Bondo and Bondo over it. Now, do I really need to use fiberglass and Bondo all up on this thing right here? Yeah, not really. But why am I doing it? Because it's awesome and it's a lot of fun. If you've never messed with Bondo or fiberglass, man, you really haven't messed with some really fun guy stuff. All right, so is it overkill? Absolutely. Why am I doing it? Yeah, because it's fun as crap, so that's why I'm doing it. All right, so that's why we're gonna fiberglass, Bondo, and really make this thing look really cool before we get done with it. Let's pull this bad boy apart. Now, if you don't know how to pull a computer case apart, I'm a little disappointed in you, but I will show you some of the tricks that I use to keep from messing stuff up so I have to fix it later. What do I mean by that? Well, when you pull the face of a case off in the back, you can really screw some things up if you're not careful. And can you fix them? Absolutely. But why, if you can just do it right the first time and keep from screwing it up and having to come back and fix something? So I'll show you what I do. All right, the first thing is pull the back part of the case off. Okay, once you got the back of the case off, if you haven't noticed yet, I already pulled all the guts out. All right, but you just pull all the guts out. Pull the motherboard out, pull the power supply out, pull everything out. It's pretty important because if you get paint on any of that stuff, it's done and you're just gonna have to buy a new piece. Next thing, the drives. The drives, you just unscrew them in the sides and then they pop right out. All right, this is a dinosaur, you can toss this. Out forward or out backward, it comes out either way. Now, this is a CD-ROM. This is a dinosaur, but you can still use it, and I'm actually gonna use this in another project, so I'm holding on to this one. I told you I was getting rid of this, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the face off of it, face of this off, and then when I fiberglass over, I'll have it sitting right here so the fiberglass has something to sit on top of. Besides that, if you're using a 3x5 drive, just like I said, you need to wake up. It is the 2000s now. So, all right, that's pretty much it for pulling it apart. The last thing is the face. Now, the face usually has little clips around the outside. Just take your time, go by, start at the top and work your way down. And if you do that, you can keep from busting these plastic clips, and it goes on a lot easier when you try to put this thing back together. To pull a face off of a disk drive, all you have to do is, there is a trick. You've gotta pull the disk drive itself out first and pull this little face off so you can get the main plate off. Usually if you just turn it over, you can push this thing right off. This one had some little clips right here, but as soon as you get those off, this front piece will slide off, and now this big face of your drive will come right off. usually one on the top and one's on the side. This one had a little extra one right there, a little extra one right there, and it's all ready to come off. So there you go. Now you've got your face, you can put that in there, and then you can mount this into the rest of your project when you're getting ready to paint it so it all matches. Pretty cool, huh?
First, I just cut my fiberglass to size. Then I mix the resin and hardener together. This is just the cheap stuff you can get at any auto parts store, and it's really easy to use. Once I've got it mixed up, I just lay the resin onto the fabric and make sure it's all spread out. Once this dries, I'm ready for my Bondo. Bondo is super simple. You just mix the Bondo and the hardener together, and then you just lay it down on top of your project. Now the fiberglass is dry, so it's ready to go. And then you just smooth it out as much as possible. The more you smooth Bondo out, the less you have to go back and sand. But if you screw it up, it's really not a big deal. Bondo will sand smooth no matter how messy it looks. Now I just go back and I sand the Bondo down. Here I'm using 320 grit just to cut through the Bondo as fast as possible. With Bondo, you usually have to go back two or three times to really get it to fill in where you want it to. And then each time you just sand it down. Well, that's pretty much it for this step. Part two is on the way, so stand by. We'll be right back.